हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर कौशल किशोर सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट SNPIT एंड RC उमराग, बावेन बारडोली, गुजरात. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट फ्लूइड फ्लो ऑपरेशन. सो दिस इज द टॉपिक टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लूइड्स लाइक न्यूटोनियन एंड नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूइड्स एंड रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर एंड बाउंड्री लेयर्स. ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल सो इन दिस लेक्चर. सो न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड, नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड, रियोपेक्टिक, थिक्सोट्रोपिक, डायलेटेंट, सो दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लूड्स एंड बिंघम प्लास्टिक, बिंघम सूडो प्लास्टिक. सो व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ डिस्कसिंग दीज फ्लूड्स? व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग दीज फ्लूड्स? सो व्हाट्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज लिक्विड प्रॉपर्टीज? So more importantly, what does it matter? So if you are sizing or selecting pump mixtures or any other type of equipment that applies shear to fluid. So these are all terms you should know, and all fluids can be broken down into two basic types. So these are Newtonian and non-Newtonian fluids. So in this figure, whatever you are watching, this is the Newtonian fluid and all these others are non-Newtonian fluids. So what are the Newtonian fluids? Those are obeying the Newton's law. So what is the Newton's law like? If you are increasing the shear stress, then the shear rate is also increasing and you are getting the straight line. But in other case, like if you will take the Bingham plastic, then first you have to increase the shear stress for a certain amount, then shear rate will start to increase. So these all have different phenomena compared than the this Newtonian fluids. So in detail we will discuss next types of Newtonian fluid and non-Newtonian fluids, and with examples in detail we will discuss all these things. So what is the Newtonian fluid? So in Newtonian fluids, viscosity remains constant no matter the amount of shear applied for a constant temperature. So these fluids have a linear relationship, whatever we have seen in that figure. So these fluids have a linear relationship between viscosity and shear stress. So here, for example, water, this is the Newtonian fluid, mineral oil, gasoline, alcohol. So all these are the Newtonian fluids because these all are obeying the Newton's law. So now we will see what is the non-Newtonian fluids. So you can probably guess that non-Newtonian fluids are the opposite of Newtonian fluids. So when shear is applied to non-Newtonian fluids, the viscosity of the fluid is changes. So the behavior of the fluid can be described one of four ways. For example, dilatant, pseudoplastic, rheopectic, thixotropic. So now we will discuss in detail about all these four examples. So dilatant, viscosity of the fluid increases when shear is applied. So for example, quicksand, corn flour and water and silly putty. So these are the example of dilatant, and in this figure if you will see, you will increase the viscosity and the stress, then this kind of behavior you will get in case of dilatant. In case of pseudoplastic, it is just opposite. So next we will discuss what is the pseudoplastic. So pseudoplastic is the opposite of dilatant. So the more shear applied, the less viscous it becomes. So for example, ketchup. So this is ketchup is the pseudoplastic fluid. So now we will discuss what is the rheopectic and thixotropic fluid. So rheopectic is very similar to dilatant in that when shear is applied and viscosity increases. So the difference here is that viscosity increases is time dependent. For example, gypsum paste and cream. So thixotropic fluids with thixotropic properties decreases in viscosity when shear is applied. So this is a time dependent property as well. For example, paint, cosmetics, asphalt and glue. So now we will see what is the rheopactic and thixotropic behavior in the plot. So this chart shows how viscosity changes in respect to shear applied over time to the flow. So this is on y-axis is the viscosity and on x-axis it is stress over time. So if you will plot this and you will see the behavior on this chart, then rheopactic will come like this and thixotropic will come like this. So this is just the opposite of rheopactic. So these are the most important fluids, Newtonian and non-Newtonian fluids. So now we will we are knowing why we are doing the study of fluids. So for selecting the pump or mixture, so it is very necessary to know the type of fluid. So how much power it needs for mixing the these kind of fluids, and which kind of pump is needed for transporting the fluid from one place to another. So this was the importance. Now we will discuss about the Reynolds number. So what is a Reynolds number? So Reynolds number is a dimensionless quantity that is used to determine the type of flow pattern as laminar or turbulent while flowing through a pipe. So Reynolds number is defined by the ratio of inertial forces to that of viscous forces. So now we will see the mathematical form of Reynolds number, Reynolds formula. So it is given by this following relation, like Reynolds number is equal to inertial force upon viscous force. So it is dV rho upon mu. So where Re is the Reynolds number and rho is the density of the fluid, and V is the velocity of flow, and D is the diameter of pipe, and mu is the viscosity of fluid. So if the Reynolds number calculated is high, greater than 2000, then the flow through the pipe is said to be turbulent. And if Reynolds number is low, less than 2000, the flow is said to be laminar. So numerically, these are acceptable values, although in general, the laminar and turbulent flows are classified according to a range. So laminar flow falls below Reynolds number of 1100 and turbulent falls in a range greater than 2200. So laminar flow is the type of flow in which the fluid travels smoothly in regular path. So conversely, turbulent flow is not smooth and follows an irregular path with lots of mixing. So here you can see this figure. So this is an illustration depicting laminar and turbulent flow. So this is the example of turbulent flow and this is the example of laminar flow. So if you are opening the tab, then you will see that when you will open very little, you will move the tab very little, then very small water will come out. So you will see one layer is just coming and it is just looking like a wire, water is falling down. So it is just in a streamline, straight streamline like this. So water is not disturbed, it is just coming in a like a wire shape. And when you will open the tap fully or more, then the flow will be zigzag, So some water will go this side, that side, and that flow is known as the turbulent flow. So this is shown in this figure. So the Reynolds number is named after the British physicist Osborne Reynolds. He discovered this while observing different fluid flow characteristics like a flow of liquid through a pipe and motion of an airplane wing through the air. So he also observed that the type of flow can transition from laminar to turbulent quite suddenly. So now we will see the some problem like calculate Reynolds number if a fluid having viscosity of 0.4 Newton second per meter square and relative density of 900 kg per meter cube through a pipe of 20 mm with a velocity of 2.5 meter. So this we will see the solution here. Like here viscosity of fluid is given, so it is mu is equal to 0.5 Newton second per meter square, and density of fluid is it is also given. So diameter of the fluid is L is equal to 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, and Reynolds number formula we have seen, so it is rho v L upon mu, and we will just put all these values here. So we will find out the value of Reynolds number. It is 112.5. So from the above answer, we observe the Reynolds number value is less than 2000. Therefore, the flow of the liquid will be the laminar. So by this way, we are calculating the Reynolds number, and then we are just analyzing the flow. It is laminar or turbulence. So now we will discuss the some practice questions on properties of fluid. So these are the easy definitions you can remember. So like first question is, what is fluid? So anything that has the property to flow categorizes as a fluid. So any substance which can flow, that is the fluid. And what are the types of matter enfolded under fluids? So liquids and gases are enfolded under fluids because liquid and gases only can flow, solid cannot flow. So this is the fluids, liquid and gases both are fluids. So now give an example for fluids. So these are the example in your daily life you have seen: water, oxygen, molten lava, etc. And many fluids you have seen, like a petrol, diesel, oil, so many things, all are fluids. And in gases, so here they have just written one gas like oxygen, if and all gases are fluids only. So next question is, name the properties of fluids. So there are three properties of fluids, namely kinematic, thermodynamic and physical properties. So now we will see what is the kinematic property of fluid. So kinematic properties such as the velocity and acceleration. So this is the kinematic property. And what is the thermodynamic property of fluid? So thermodynamic property of fluid such as density, temperature, internal energy, pressure, specific volume and specific weight. So all these properties comes under the thermodynamic property of the fluid. So now name the physical property of the fluid. So what are the physical property of the fluid? So physical property of fluid such as appearance, color and odor. So kis tarah which kind of it is appearance has the fluid, and what is the color and odor of that fluid. So all these comes in the physical properties of that particular fluid. So now we will see, arrange the following terms in the ascending order of their density, like water, carbon dioxide, air and seawater. डेंसिटी मीन्स गैसेस ऑलवेज हैव अ डेंसिटी लेस कंपेयर देन द लिक्विड. सो दैट्स व्हाई लिक्विड इज दिस साइड एंड गैसेस आर दिस साइड. सो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड हैव अ लेस डेंसिटी कंपेयर देन द एयर एंड ऑल दीज गैसेस हैव अ लेस डेंसिटी कंपेयर देन द वाटर एंड सी वाटर हैव द हाइएस्ट डेंसिटी बिकॉज इट हैव अ मैनी मिनरल्स content like sodium, chlorine, potassium, so many things. And this sodium chloride is in high amounts. That's why it is have the high density. So now define the specific volume. So specific volume is expressed as the volume that a fluid occupies per unit mass. So this also we have discussed in first lecture in the properties of fluid. So what is the relation between specific volume and density? So specific volume is the reciprocal of density. So it is very close with the density. So now we will see laminar and turbulent boundary layers. So this is the plot, stress versus velocity. So this is for laminar and this is for the turbulent. So this is typical velocity profile for laminar and turbulent boundary layers. A boundary layer may be laminar or turbulent. So a laminar boundary layer is one where the flow takes place in layers. So each layer slides past the adjacent layer. So this is in contrast to turbulent boundary layers shown in the in this figure. So where there is an intense agitation. So in turbulent, you can see this is the intense agitation. In a laminar boundary layer, any exchange of mass or momentum takes place only between adjacent layers on a microscopic scale, which is not visible to the eye. So consequently, molecular viscosity mu is able to predict the shear stress associated. So laminar boundary layer are found only when the Reynolds number are small. So a turbulent boundary layer, on the other hand, is marked by mixing across several layers of it. So the mixing is now on a microscopic scale and packets of fluid may be seen moving across. So thus there is an exchange of mass, momentum and energy on a much bigger scale. So compared to a laminar boundary layer, a turbulent boundary layer forms only at larger Reynolds number. So the scale of mixing cannot be handled by molecular viscosity alone. So those calculating turbulent flow rely on what is called turbulence viscosity or eddy viscosity, so which has no exact expression. So it has to be modeled. Several models have been developed for this purpose. So now again we will see in a one plot how the profile is coming of laminar and turbulent. Then laminar is coming like this and turbulent is coming like this. So typical velocity profile for laminar and turbulent boundary layers. So these shear stress versus velocity profile for the laminar boundary layer and turbulent boundary layer comes like this. As a consequence of intense mixing, a turbulent boundary layer has a steep gradient velocity at the wall and therefore a large shear stress. So in addition, heat transfer rates are also high. And typical laminar and turbulent boundary layer profile are shown in that above figure. So typical velocity profile for laminar and turbulent boundary layers growth rate, the rate at which the boundary layer thickness delta of a laminar boundary layer is small. So for a flat plate, it is given by delta upon x, it is 5 upon root rex. So this is the Reynolds number. So where rex is the Reynolds number based on the length of the plate. For a turbulent flow, it is given by delta upon x is equal to 0.385 upon rex to the power 0.2. So here we will see wall shear stress is another parameter of interest in boundary layers. So it is usually expressed as skin friction, defined as CF is equal to tau W upon 1 by 2 rho U square infinite. So here tau W is the wall shear stress given by tau W is equal to mu del U upon del Y, and here Y is equal to 0. So U is infinite is the free stream speed, and skin friction for laminar and turbulent flows are given by CF is equal to 0.664 upon root Reynolds, and this is for laminar, and this CF 0.0594 upon REX 0.2 it is for turbulent. So now we will see the boundary layer formation in a straight tube. So considering a straight thin walled tube with fluid entering it at a uniform velocity as shown in this figure. So a boundary layer begins to form at the entrance to the tube, and as the fluid moves to the first part of the channel, so the boundary layer thickness during this stage, the boundary layer occupies only a part of the tube or total stream, consists of a core of fluid moves like a rod like manner. So here like this, it is just looking like a rod structure, it is moving like a rod, but the velocity of fluid is constant. So in the boundary layer, the velocity varies from zero to constant velocity existing in the core. So as we further move down to the tube, the boundary layer occupies an increased portion of the cross section of the tube. So at this point, the velocity distribution in the tube reaches its final point and remains unchanged for the remaining part of the fluid. So whatever you are watching, it is slowly becoming like in this shape. So first it was flat, then it is becoming curved, and then it is reaching. So this is the final stage. So this is comes in the irrotational flow region, and this is velocity boundary layer. And this is developing velocity profile, and this is fully developed profile. So this profile and this profile is similar. So here this is hydrodynamic entrance region, and this is the fully developed region. So here this is called the unchanging velocity distribution and fully developed flow. Now we will discuss about the transition length. So what is the transition length? The length of the entrance region of the tube necessary for the boundary layer to reach the center of the tube and for the fully developed flow to be established is called transition length. So we can express it by xt upon d is equal to 0.05 into nre. So here xt is the transition length, d is equal to the diameter of the tube. So all these things we have discussed in this lecture. Thank you.